Welcome to one of the most advanced sniper guides in the history of Battlefield. All the footage that you see here today is from Battlefield Hardline, but make no mistake, everything that you will learn is applicable to Battlefield 4, Battlefield Hardline, and most likely to Battlefield 5. All the Sniper University videos that you have seen on Fog of Gaming have been preparing you for this. You didn't know about it, because I didn't tell you that when I was making these videos. But they have been part of a bigger plan. About 10 months ago, I had the idea to show you how to kill drivers and pilots with a sniper rifle. I couldn't just make a video about this without showing you the basics and giving you the necessary time to practice. If you have been watching the previous videos and if you have applied everything that was shown, then you are now ready. You are now ready to kill drivers and pilots. You will be able to do this consistently, not only once or twice with a lucky shot. You will be able to do this multiple times per round. I will show you how you can do this in Battlefield Hardline, but know that everything is applicable to Battlefield 4 and Battlefield 5. I will show you everything in a few different chapters. Chapter 1 will be the basic kills. Then you will see the advanced kills, and for the expert players among you, I will show you some pretty extreme kills. Chapter 1 are the basic kills that don't require a lot of special skills or special timing or anything like that. The only thing that these kills require is patience. Patience for the right timing, so that you can make an easy kill. Chapter 2 will require more from your side. They require more skill, knowledge and timing, and they might require multiple shots depending on the range or gun. The final chapter will cover extreme kills, and they will require a lot of skill from your side, you will need a lot of knowledge, and you will need the perfect timing. Let's start with chapter 1, basic kills. These kills are the ones that everyone can make, so I will keep it short and simple. For the expert players, you can use skills like this to get used to a new gun, to see how the bullet behaves, and to get used to the muzzle velocity and the bullet drop. But soon you will move on to something more advanced. Use these basic kills to develop your sniping skills. I will explain everything step by step. Step 1 is the practice shot. By far, the most efficient way to know where and how to aim. If you have an idea of the distance to your target, then fire one practice round and track the bullet. This bullet will tell you where it will hit and you have just figured out with which part of the scope you have to aim with. This is your starting position. I still use this practice shot method to make my extreme kills, which I will show you later in the video. For step 2, you will have to find a stationary target. This is very easy to do in Battlefield. Just find a guy who is about to enter a vehicle and he will be stationary long enough for you to kill him. Use your minimap to find a guy like this. There is absolutely no need to lie down and aim through your scope for about 5 minutes. The reason why you have to find a stationary target is very simple. You have to get used to sniping people in cars. The objective is to snipe a guy out of a moving vehicle. But before you can do this, you need the necessary amount of practice. You have to get used to shooting drivers and passengers, and the best way to start is with a stationary target. Sometimes you will have to wait to find a stationary target, and sometimes one will literally fall out of the sky. These guys really parked their heli in the wrong spot. This is the next step. Kill the driver and passenger when they are stationary or almost stationary. This is a variation of the previous step, but this time you will have to wait until they are stationary. You would be surprised on how many times a vehicle comes to a grinding halt in Battlefield. Some guys miss their turn, they drive over a bump and they lose control, and some guys even stop to pick up their bodies. Use these random opportunities to make your kills, but wait until they are stationary. Make it easy for yourself. Your basic sniping skills are going to improve a lot if you do everything that I will show you in this video. But as you can imagine, the better your skills were before the video, the easier it will be to kill the driver. So keep working on developing your skills. Shoot at everything that moves, because every bullet counts. But keep it simple, and when the opportunity arises, kill the driver when he is not moving. It's all about timing. In this chapter, it is important to wait long enough until your enemy is stationary. This will make your life a lot easier and his life a lot shorter. Step 4 needs some explaining before I actually show you what you have to do. The great thing about Battlefield is that you will get access to a lot of sniper rifles. Some are good and some are not so good. I'm not going to tell you which ones to use, but I will advise you to try out all of them. Each gun will teach you something. One gun might teach you to be patient, another will force you to go for headshots, and some guns will require you to shoot a lot of bullets. In Battlefield, you will be able to shoot with bolt-action sniper rifles, and you will be able to shoot with semi-auto sniper rifles. In step 4, you will have to shoot a lot of bullets, so we are going to choose a semi-auto sniper rifle. If you want to kill somebody who is in a moving vehicle, whether it is a car or a helicopter, you need to learn where you have to shoot to kill a specific passenger. This is not as obvious as it sounds. You know that most vehicles have occupants, and you think that you know where they are seated. For a car, it's pretty obvious, but everything changes when you start shooting at a helicopter. It will pitch up, pitch down, and it will bank left or right. All of these movements will obviously change the location of the passengers inside. It is up to you to figure out where they are. You won't have time to think about this when you are on the battlefield. The best way to figure this out is to shoot a lot of bullets. Shoot at the helicopter from every possible angle and try to find out what works and what doesn't. Do the same thing for cars, and later on you will be able to make a difficult kill with only one shot. As you can see, I am increasing the difficulty step by step. It will make this video easy to follow, and you will see a steady progression in your own sniping skills. There is a learning curve, and throughout this video you will see part of my learning curve. You need to experiment on how the bullets hit the moving target, and the only way to learn this is to shoot. The more bullets that you shoot, the more experience that you get, and the less bullets that you will need to kill. The objective is one shot, one kill. In step 5, we will go over from stationary targets and shooting a lot of bullets to killing drivers in slow moving vehicles. We are going to increase the speed. Not your speed, but the speed of your enemy. Up to now, we have been shooting at stationary targets. Most of the time, your enemy wasn't moving. From now on, we are going to face the problem of speed. The speed of your bullet and the speed of your target. When your enemy is driving slowly, you will have to drag your scope slightly so that you can keep up with him. You don't have to lead your target yet, that is for the next step. The only thing that you will have to worry about is the direction of travel of your target. In a car or a van, it is pretty straightforward. The direction of travel will be very linear. Try to position yourself so that your target will be coming directly at you. This will keep things simple. You will have to take into account his direction of travel, but if he is coming straight at you, then it will be very easy to kill him. You can develop your skills further by changing your position so that your enemy will come at you at a more challenging angle. But make sure that they are still driving at slow speed so that you can easily take them out. Once you get used to this, we can move over to step 6. How to lead your target. When your enemy is coming at you from an angle, or when he is far away in the distance, or when you are using a gun with a slow muzzle velocity, you will have to lead your target. There is a lot of skill involved in leading your target. However, it is very easy to learn how to do this. I will give you a basic explanation now, but I will discuss this in depth in chapter 2 when I show you the advanced skills. All you have to know at this stage is that your enemy will travel at a certain speed and your bullet will travel at a certain speed. You will have to match those so that your bullet will end up hitting your enemy. If you choose a gun with a high muzzle velocity and you keep the distance and angle to your target small, then you won't have to lead your target very much. This is where we will start so that you can get used to leading your target. It will take some time to experiment with this. The best way to do this is to shoot at a moving car. In the beginning, just try to hit the car with every bullet. Once you get used to this, then start aiming at a certain window and make sure that every bullet goes through this window, and soon you will be able to do the same with your enemy. This way, you can teach yourself on how to hit a moving target, and eventually you will be able to lead your target and take it out with only one shot. Step 7 is a continuation of what you have been doing in step 6. You were just shooting at the vehicle to hit it, but now we are going to shoot at the vehicle to destroy it. This sounds easy, but you have to fire a lot of bullets and you will have to hit that car with almost every bullet that you fire. You can't do this from every location on the battlefield. You will need a large line of sight. because as you can imagine, it will take quite a few shots to destroy a car. So you will have to give yourself that time. Try to find an elevated position close to a road. When you see a car in the distance and it is likely that he will come your way, then slowly start shooting at it. Make sure that every bullet that you fire is on target. Slowly start increasing your rate of fire, like you can see here. The closer your target, the higher your rate of fire should be. You can clearly hear the increasing rate of fire as the car comes closer, and soon you will destroy the vehicle and everyone who was stupid enough to stay inside. The objective of chapter 1 is very simple. If you followed everything step by step, then you will now be able to kill a driver with only one shot. It is awesome to be able to do this, and you will be able to make some pretty nice kills. But let's be honest, we kept things simple. We positioned ourselves in an ideal location so that we can make killing easy for us. That won't be the case in chapter 2. We are going to make things difficult.